Hi guys, I welcome all the viewers in this video once again and my YouTube channel as well. So guys, as of now, if you have subscribed my channel or if you have not subscribed, then you should subscribe my channel. And as you can see, this topic is all about network certification, which is CompTIA N Plus certification, and I'm going through step by step. This is volume 1 and lesson 1 part 2. In part 1, lesson 1, I had concluded two topics, and in this video I'm just going to conclude or I will be talking about topic C, topic D and topic E. So topic C is standard network models, topic D is network topologies, and topic E is network categories. So guys, if you are finding my video informative for you, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, comment on this video, share this video, like this video. If you subscribe, then you will be getting all the upcoming videos also. So this is my YouTube URL and this is my blog. So guys, let me begin this. So as of now, as you can see here, topic C, okay, standard network models. So this is just a description here. Like previously, you have learned definition for the terms used to describe the basic building blocks and network. So you can read from here. Now I'm beginning with this very first one, which is known as the very main topic. So guys, if you are appearing in A plus N plus CompTIA certification, then there will be certain questions like this. They will be giving you blank here, and a dash dash model is designed specification for how the nodes on the network interact and communicate. So you should be knowing, and you will be getting four options like network model or something. So you should be able to recognize. So that is why I have taken the description like this. So what is network model here? So a network model is a design specification for how the nodes on network interact and communicate. So you should not worry too much about what and all here relation. You should pick up the few points only. The main point, what is the main concept here? So it is a model, okay, or it is a design, so how the nodes will be communicated or how they will be interacting on the network, that is known as network model. So you can say the design. Next thing guys, the network model determines the degree to which communication and processing are centralized or distributed. So it defines also like whether it is a processing communication like central or distributed. I will show you how. There are three primary network models. One is centralized, second one is centralized or hierarchical, second one is client server, and third one is peer-to-peer. So guys, as you can see here in this graphic, so what I was talking about, there are three types of, okay, the first one is centralized here, centralized model, second one is client server model, and third one is peer-to-peer model. So what is centralized, what is client server, what is peer-to-peer? In my previous video I have covered each and everything in a very simple way and very simple explanation or description. If you subscribe and if you want the previous videos, you should subscribe the channel and you can search from there. So you will have the better understanding about what is centralized or hierarchical and client server and peer-to-peer. So guys, these are the basic three network models. Now I will move to next one, which is centralized computing network. So we will understand this one, this first one and second one and third one by one in detail. So if we talk about centralized computing network, so a centralized network is a network in which a central host controls all network communication and perform data processing and storage on behalf of client. I hope you understood what is the meaning of this one. So let me show you the one graphic here. So guys, this is a centralized network, okay. What is the meaning of centralized here? One host will be controlling the communication, processing and storage on the behalf of clients. So these are the clients. They don't have anything like communication control, processing control, storage control. They are just you can say they are just simple systems or computers or host users, you can say. They don't have anything to store and communication and processing. So this is what is known as centralized. So for if here one more user comes, here one more users come, each and everything, that processing and storage will be happening to this host. So that is known as centralized. user connect to the host by a dedicated terminal or terminal emulators. So there will be certain emulators or terminals to connect through this host for this users. And centralized network provide high performance and centralized management, but they are also expensive to implement. Obviously, you will have to purchase very heavy configuration of that particular server, or high configuration, so it will require more cost or it will be expensive, but it will be easy to manage because everything will be at central location. So this is known as, guys, central network. So I'm moving to P2P now. Okay, so in this, what happens? First of all, you should understand the definition. A P2P network is a network in which resource sharing, processing and communication controls are completely decentralized. So here there is nothing like what I spoke on previous slide here. So nothing will be centralized. Okay, all clients on the network are equal in term of providing and using resources, and users are authenticated by each individual workstation. So guys, let me show you one more graphic here. So as you can see in this graphic, I have three computers here. Okay, one is this one, second and third. So all these computer will be having their own resources, storage, processing, communication capabilities. So they will not be depending on the centralized host. Okay, as I told in previous slide. So this is the difference between P2P and centralized network model. Now here, P2P network are easily and inexpensive to implement. So these are not very expensive, low cost. However, they are only practical in very small organization. So these kinds of implementation or model is used in a very small sort of organizations due to the lack of central data storage and administration, because they cannot afford for more money or more cost to purchase a high configuration hardware and all for the configuration of centralized computing network or model. So guys, I will move to the next one, which is third one, which is client and server network model. So what does it mean here? A client and server network is a network in which servers provide service to clients. So this much is enough to understand, guys. In this, what will happen? Server will provide services to client, and clients will be utilizing the services from the server. That is known as client server. Typically, there is at least one server providing centralized authentication service. Okay, and servers also provide access to shared file, printers, hardware and other applications. And if you want to understand more in this, in client server network, processing power, management services and administrative functions can be connected, contacted where needed. Okay, while clients can still perform many basic end user tasks on their own. I will show you one more graphic here. What does it mean? So that it will be easy to understand, because theoretical part can be little bit difficult to understand each and everything, but there is a example or a graphic that makes you a bit easy to understand. So guys, this is a scenario of client and server network model. So here I have a server, this is my server, and it is having processing power, management services, authentication functions or administrative functions. And here I have two clients. If they want to access any resource which is kept on this server, they will have to take authentication. They will have to get authentication from this server, and the server should grant permission or rights to access those resources. Then only that user can access resources from these two client system, these two client computers which is kept on this server. So this is known as client server network model. So guys, I have spoken about three. One is client server, second one is P2P, and third one is the first one, which was centralized computing network model. Okay, now I will move to next one, which is mixed mode network. So we have one more here, mixed mode network. In this, what will happen? By name itself, it is saying a mixed mode network is a network that incorporates elements from the three standard network models. So it is a combination of one If it is a combination, then definitely we'll have two network models. So it can be two network model combination or three network model combination. So that is known as mixed mode network. Now, mixed mode network uses. What are the uses here? One common example of mixed mode network is a work group created to share local resources within client server network. So it is a very simple, like I have a server here and I have created one shared IP, that is known as client server network. Okay, for example, you might share one client local printer. I have shared one printer from here and it should be available to other computers also, for other users also. The client sharing the printer on the network does not use client server network directory structure to authenticate and authorize access to the printer. Another example, guys, I will show you one graphic here. I think I have taken. Okay, so I'm not reading much there. You can read. Okay, here another example here I have taken. So I will show you here. So guys, this is my host. Okay, this is host means what? Centralized network. And this is one server I have and one peer client here. So this is a one network model. This one is second network model. And at the same time, this is can be a third network model. So it is a mixed mode network. All three networks models are concluded or used in this diagram or in this mixed mode network. So this is how we can define it is a combination of more than two or combination of two network models, which is known as mixed mode network. So guys, topic C is concluded and it is over. Now I'm moving to topic D, which is network topology. So guys, what do we mean by network? So I have already told you what is network. Network is nothing but it is a group of network objects to have a proper communication and resource sharing. That is known as network. Okay. And topology. What do you mean by topology? It is a combination of two words. So I have clearly said what is the meaning of network. Now what is the meaning of topology? So guys, topology is nothing but it is a structure of your network. How you are defining, how you are structuring your network, that is known as topology. Okay, physical structure of your network is known as network topology. So we will understand one by one in this topic. So guys, topology, what do you mean by topology here? So a topology is a network specification that determines the network's overall layout and the network's data flow pattern. So how your data will be flowing from one place to another place and how your network will be structured. So that is a kind of a specification defined by the topology, or topology can be a design itself, okay, or a specification or layout of your network. Now a topology comprises the physical topology, which describes the network's physical wiring layout or shape. Okay, so it is a combination of two things. One is physical and second one is logical. So physical is what you can see, or the physical layout or shape or wiring, how it the wiring will be take place. Now second one is logical topology. So what do you mean by logical topology here? So guys, nothing but it's a path or logically how that data will be traveling from one place to another place throughout your network. That is known as logical topology. Okay, now the physical and logical topologies do not have to be the same. So both cannot be same. Okay, or it's not mandated that both should be same. Common topology includes a star pattern, ring pattern, and bus or straight line patterns. So I will show you all those things one by one. So guys, this is a network topology. Okay, I will tell you. I told you it is a combination of two things. One is physical and second one is logical. So this you can see, this is a cable, okay, and these are the computers. So this is showing how your computer should be connected. Okay, that is what your physical. Now what is logical here? So logical means what? From here, if any data has to go to this computer, how it will go? It will go like here, from this 1 to 2 or 2 to 3, 2 to 3 to 4, like this. It can go, or like it can go by like this also, 1 2 3 4 5. So this is what logical topology and physical topology we have. The physical topology is layout, physically wiring and all. logical how your data will be traveling, because you cannot define how this data will be traveling. It can go from here, or it can go 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, or it can go to 1 to 3, 3 to 4, or 1 to 2, 2 to 4. So this is how you cannot define how it will be traveling, but you can assume, okay, and your physical topology and your logical topology will not be same. So guys, the first one is physical bus topology. So this is the first one, okay, physical bus topology. I'm talking about physical bus, not logical. So what do you mean by this? A physical bus topology is a physical topology in which network nodes are arranged in a linear format, with each node connected directly to network cable with a T connectors or tab. So this much is enough to tell you guys what does it mean. So it is a connection in which all the nodes will be connecting through a cable, okay, or you can say there will be certain media or device to connect, which is also known as T connectors. I will show you how. Second thing, guys, the data signal passes by the nodes, not through the node. Okay, a bus network is easy to implement but can be unreliable, because the entire bus fail if there is a break in the wire. Signals can reflect off the end of the wire, so you need to install transmitter at both ends of the bus. So guys, I will tell you what does it mean. So this is what you can see here and understand what is the bus topology. So this is a physical bus topology. I have three computers here, 1, 2, 3. Okay, now all three computers are connected through T connectors here, and this all the three connectors, this T connectors are connected in one cable only. So if this cable goes down, entire topology will be down. So it is easy to implement but difficult to manage it, or you can say that it is not reliable. You cannot rely on this. So this is what, guys, we have in bus topology. Okay, now I'm moving to next one. Next one is, guys, star topology. So star, this is a kind of physical topology again. Okay, I'm talking about physical topology. So first one is bus topology inside that. Now I'm talking about star, physical star topology. So by name itself, it is saying what does it mean. So guys, what will happen in star topology? The layout of this topology will be like a star. Okay, one central device will be there, and that will be communicating throughout all the nodes. So same thing must be mentioned here. A physical star topology is a network topology that uses a central connectivity device such as hub, okay, with separate connections to each node. There I will show you how individual nodes send data to the hub when the hub gives them to turn. The hub sends the data back out again to the destination node, because a single failed node does not bring down the whole network. Star topology are reliable and easy to maintain. So guys, this is a example here. What does it mean? This could be switch, okay, and this is hub I have taken here. So I have four computers, 1, 2, 3, and 4, for example. Now this A has to send some data to 4. So how it will happen? This will send the data to this central device. Now that central device will send data to particularly this 4 number. It will not send that data to 2, or it will not send that data to 3. So this is what, if this 2 is down, nothing will happen. Still data communication can happen properly. But what will happen in this bus topology? If that all systems are connected through one cable, if that one cable is down, so my entire communication will be down and I won't be able to send the data. So same thing is here, but this one is a bit good or reliable as compared to star bus topology. So here again there is some advantage and disadvantage also. Advantages, it is easy to implement, okay, and one node failure will not impact your entire network setup. But if your central device is down, if your switch is down or your hub is down, your entire topology will be down. So this is one disadvantage is having to this topology. So you should be knowing advantages also and disadvantages also of all the topologies. So star topology are reliable and easy to maintain, but I told you, if your central device is down, your network will be down, because it won't be able to transfer your data to destination. Next one is, guys, physical ring topology. What do you mean by physical ring topology? So NIME itself, it is again saying all the nodes will be communicated in the form of ring. Okay, so you can read here, a physical ring topology is a network topology in which all network nodes are connected in a continuous circle. Each node in turn reads the network signal from its upstream neighbor and then retransmit it to the downstream neighbor. So signal quality is high. So in this, what will happen? I will show you what does it mean. So the meaning is very simple. All nodes will be communicating or connected, will be connecting in a single ring. Because the failure of single node can bringing down the whole network, ring topologies are potentially unreliable. So as you can understand here, guys, what is the meaning of ring? So all four computers are connected through one ring. Okay, this is known as ring topology. So it is reliable, not much, because if my one host is down or one node is down, my entire network will be down. So this is a disadvantage of creating or using ring topology. But here, if your topology is okay, your wiring or cabling is okay, it will give you good quality of the data transmission. Because what happens if this is a sender device, okay, and it is sending to this is a receiving device, if any data has to come to from there, so there is a wait time here. Okay, so if anything has to come this side, it will listen what is the status of this computer. If this data is sending, I mean this host is sending, so if this host is ready to send any data to throughout that ring topology, this S will wait for some time. I mean this sender will wait for some time. If nothing is happening, then he will send the data. So it provides speed and good quality. Okay, and let me move to the next one, guys. So this is not a reliable. Okay, next one is maze topology. So guys, by name again itself saying what does it mean by maze topology. So a physical maze topology is a network topology in which each node has a direct connection to every other nodes. Okay, so if I have 10 nodes, all 10 nodes will be connecting to each other by direct connection. This topology is extremely reliable because no nodes can ever be isolated from the network. So it is a very you can say reliable, because I will show you what does it mean and how it is reliable. So it is also extraordinarily difficult to implement and maintain because the number of connections increases exponentially with the number of nodes. So the meaning is very simple. If you are using maze topology, you will have lots of wiring, lots of cables, because each and every system should be, each and every computer, each and every node should be able to directly connected with other nodes. So cabling will be very high and it will be very huge or risky work to maintain that one. I will show you how. This is the one I will show you here how. Maze topology are typically used to provide reliable connections between separate independent network. So guys, this is a very small example here. So as you can see here, I have four computers. Okay, four computers, these two, there is nothing gap in this. For example, if I tell you 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, four computers. Now if A1 want to send to data to this fourth computer, so this data can come. Let me take a different color here. So now this A wants to send data to fourth, so it has three routes, one A, B, this one, okay, from here, and C. Three routes it is having. If this fails, still the data transmission can happen from here, still the data transmission can happen here. So this is how it is very useful. But as you can see here, one cable here, one cable here, one cable here, so three cables we need to put here to make this kind of configuration. So it is very complex to maintain. And it is very difficult to troubleshoot it because you will be having lots of cables. Now you won't be able to understand which cable is down because still your data communication will be happening, but still your cable is down. So this is what you need to take care of, the selection of topologies. Guys, next one is hybrid topology. So what do you mean by hybrid topology? A hybrid topology is a any topology that exists characteristics of more than one standard physical topology. So you can say it is a combination of two physical topology. Each section of the network follow the rule of its own topology. So every section will be having their own rules to follow in the topology, and they can be complex to maintain because they incorporate a wide range of technologies. So this is a example of hybrid topology. For example, this is your bus topology, guys, this one. Okay, this is your ring topology. Okay, and this is your, just now I told you which one, it is maze topology. So it is a combination of more than one physical topology, which is known as hybrid topology. And for that you will have to install and configure multiple different devices like switches, router and all. So it will be challenging for you to manage. Next one is, guys, so physical topology is over here. Now I'm going to talk about logical topology. So first one is logical bus topology. Okay, so definition is very simple. A logical bus topology is a network topology in which all nodes see the network signal at the same time. Okay, so all the nodes, either it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, they will see the network signal at the same time. They will be hearing, or they will be knowing, or they will be keen to understand what is the situation of signal on the network, regardless of the physical wiring layout of the network. Okay, I will show you how it is. Even though the node might be connected to central hub and resemble a star, the data flow appear to move in single continuous stream. So I'm not reading this much, guys, it requires lots of energy. So I can explain you through this graphic. So this is a logical bus topology here. So I'm telling you what does it mean, whatever I read here. Okay, this is a centralized device here. Okay, this is a sender device, and I have three receivers here. Okay, 1, 2, and 3. So as soon as the data comes to this, all will be able to hear that. They are ready to see what is the signal status on the network at the same time. Okay, this is known as bus topology, logical bus topology. Next one is logical ring topology. What do you mean by logical ring topology? So guys, a logical ring topology is a network topology in which each node receives data only from its upstream neighbor and retransmit it only to its downstream neighbor. So I will tell you in previous slide also, in physical topology I missed to tell you about this one. So I will explain you what does it mean, what is upstream neighbors and downstream neighbors here. Although the nodes might be connected to a central device or star layout, and data moves through the network in continuous circle. So this is what I'm trying to tell you, a logical ring topology. Okay, so here you can take anyone, like data is going from here. Okay, so it will keep moving like this. If it is starting from here, or so this system will get data from this system will get data, this system will get data from here, this, that is known as upstream. Okay, so it will keep moving in a ring. Next one is, guys, logical star topology. A logical star topology is implemented less commonly than logical ring or bus topology. In a logical star topology, all nodes might be wired onto same bus circle, but a central device poll each node to see if it needs to transmit, and then controls the amount of access the nodes has to the cable. So let me take a graphic here so it will be easy to understand. So guys, in this, simply One mux will be required, okay. Multiplexer, that is also known as mux device, manages the separate signal and enables them to share the media. So this play a very important role here in this star topology. So it will be receiving all the signals from the nodes and it will be forwarding those nodes to a particular computer or node to where it has to go. Now topic E. So guys, topic D is also concluded. Now we'll be going to network categories. Okay, so we have spoken about standards, network standards, then network models and network topologies. Now we are talking about network categories. So guys, very simple. First one is local area connection. I hope I do not need to tell much thing here. Local LAN is stand for local area network. Is a self-contained network that spans a small area such as single building, floor or room, that is known as LAN. Okay, in a LAN, all nodes and segments are directly connected with cable or short range wireless technologies. So like this is a one building. Okay, I have two buildings. So floor one, I'm talking about floor one, not entire building, that is known as LAN one. And in same building, I have one more floor or room. Inside that, I have a couple of computers, that is known as LAN. Next one is LAN administrator duties. What are the duties of LAN administrator? So first one is, guys, LAN administrator are specifically charged with the managing and maintaining the local network. Okay, the administrator's responsibility include maintaining not only machines, cabling, but also network softwares. So the next duty of network LAN administrator is, LAN administrator might also perform installation, deployment, upgrades and troubleshooting for applications. Other thing, like LAN administrators are typically versatile and adaptable with broad range of skills and knowledge. So these are the basic responsibility, you can say, the duties of LAN administrator. So now next one is, guys, WAN, which is known as wide area network. So what do you mean by wide area network? So wide area network is a network that spans multiple geographic locations. For example, this is a world, okay, and I have one in Bangalore, one in Mumbai, and one is in Calcutta. So these are the geographical locations, multiple, and they are connected with each other. Okay, that is known as WAN. WANs typically connect multiple LANs using long range transmission media. And guys, again, we have certain duties of WAN administrator. So WAN administrator tend to be more technical than LAN administrator and focus more on network issues than user issues. So the LAN administrator will be taking care of users issues, but the WAN administrator will have to look for the network issues as well. A WAN administrator is the one who designs and maintains the connection scheme between remote office and deal with LAN communication devices and interfaces. So the WAN administrator has little bit more or high responsibilities. Guys, there are certain more like metropolitan, campus and other network coverage areas. Like I will tell you here, first one, if you talk about MAN, M-A-N stand for Metropolitan Area Network, which covers an area equivalent to a city or other municipality. Okay, so sometimes these are also very important from the exam point of view. Next one is, guys, Campus Area Network, okay, which is also known as CAN, capital letter, which covers an area equivalent to an academic campus or business park. A CAN is typically owned or used exclusively by one company, a school or organization. And again, we have GAN, that is also known as Global Area Network. So guys, which is any worldwide network. Okay, so we should be knowing all those things. One question can be expected in the exam. Next one is, guys, the internet. So the internet is the single largest global WAN, okay, linking virtually every country, continent, organization in the world. So no single person, country or entity owns or control the internet. So one will not having the control over the internet. Okay, it is a virtual connection between everybody or individual, each and everything, you can say, in term of country, continent, organization, like that. Instead, internet standards and practice are overseen by an international consortium that is coordinated by the Internet society. So there is a society who takes care of internet and all standards. So I'm not going much in that. So as you can see here, guys, this is the internet. You are connected throughout the world. You can't say anything here. This is one LAN, one organization. Second LAN, second organization, multiple. So you are connected through. This is India. This is China. This is America, US. So each and everything is connected. Now, guys, next one is intranets. Okay, what do you mean by intranets? An intranet is a private network that employs internet style technologies. Okay, intranets are a popular method of corporate communication because employee can use their internet skill to obtain private company information. How? As you can see here, for example, it is an intranet. You can say this is one intranet now. This is one boundary inside one particular boundary restricted area. So employee handbook, employees handbook, employees information will be kept here, and this is through internet. Once again, this information is kept here. This is office, and multiple users are here, so they can access those things inside your particular premises. That is known as intranet. Guys, what do you mean by extranets now? What do you mean by? So extranet is a private network that employs internet style technology to enable communication between two or more separate organizations or companies. So company A, company B can communicate with each other. That is known as extranet. And this was inside one company only. That is known as intranets. One of the company that participate in extranet might own, build, maintain and control it, and then share the access to the specific partner or other company. Or extranet partner might all share the responsibilities for developing the internet. So one will be having control of all the resources, and the second will be accessing those resources with the permission what the one company or A company is providing to B company. So this is what I was talking about extranet, guys. Here I have company C, company B, company A here. Okay, so now I have given access to company C and company B, but I have not given access to company A. So this is how I can control the access to my resources for the companies in extranets. Next one is, guys, enterprise network. An enterprise network is a network that encompasses all the separate network component employed by particular organization. So one organization will be dealing with this all the separate networks. Okay, for example, I have one branch, that is my enterprise branch in Bangalore. I have couple of in Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata, like that. So these are my separate branch, but my entire will be in Bangalore. So that is known as enterprise network. I will be managing each and everything from there only. An enterprise network can be any size required by the organization and can employ any number of networking technologies. So there is no limitation of usage of technologies and the size of the organizations. That is known as enterprise. So this is what, guys, this I have organization, that is my Narayan.com or Narayan is my company name, and I have certain one office here, one office in, as I told you, and over the internet I am connected and network topologies, and these are the, you can say, multiple physical locations or separate network that are communicated over the internet with each other, and this entire one is my enterprise network, whatever it is. So guys, this is what I tried to brought in this video, and I hope this video is informative. As I spoke you in the beginning of this video, if you find it is helpful, please don't forget to subscribe channel, comment this video on this video, like this video and share this video. If you share this video, then obviously it will reach to the other people also, and that is a big help. So guys, thanks watching for this video. Please comment, like, share and subscribe my channel, and wait for my next videos. And next videos I will be talking about network communication methods, which is lesson 2, and you can subscribe my channel. This is a URL of my channel, and this is a blog. So till then, bye bye guys.